I want to be alone. Anywhere we are is home. I want to be alone. Anywhere we are is home.
Come on. Hey. Oh, it's so nice to meet you.
Okay, I'm not this fly. I just don't want you to see me crying. Oh my God.
You're looking fly. I love it.
It's really great to meet you.
I know. I'm never
nervous, by the way. Meeting you is almost like a manifestation that everything I dreamed is happening. You were some guy that lived on my phone.
Yeah.
That taught me C major.
Yeah.
That taught me A minor pentatonic.
Yeah.
And why you go down 3½ steps so you can solo right there.
Yeah.
I didn't understand theory, but you made me understand it in a way that I could follow my dreams and I can make it relevant for me. I can never play like all these guys, but you taught me how to play like me.
Wow.
And I cannot express to you how much that changed my whole life.
Hey guys, Marty Schwartz here with Marty Music. We're doing an episode of Guitar Tours. We're in Nashville, Tennessee at like the most famous rehearsal space called Soundcheck. So you might hear a little rehearsal noise in the background. But I'm so honored to have artist Juno here. And we've been hanging out and having
yes.
a great time. Now, one thing I want to say besides, humbled that you learned from my videos,
yes.
We got that out of the way. What I think's so inspiring is just your story of not being a musician
yeah.
to being a musician. So let me get this right. You were a social worker?
Yes. So let me take off my glasses here, Marty Schwartz, because I didn't want you to see me crying earlier, but I'm ready to talk.
All right.
So I was a social worker. My first client after graduating college was a 15-year-old heroin addict, actually.
Yeah.
It was a drug rehab facility program.
Okay.
And I was there to help him get back into the world. Well, he wouldn't talk to me. All he wanted to do was play his guitar. So I knew the only way to talk to him was through the guitar. He taught me G major, C major, D major. And I think I found 7 million songs to play with those chords.
Yes, absolutely.
And I've been playing, like literally ever since the day that he showed me those chords, I've been playing every single day.
Wow.
Since then. And it literally, like, my life was going like this, and I said,
pivot.
Yeah. And I want to put this out there. I would have been a bomb social worker. I was about to say that. Okay. I don't want people to think
because
I gave
you
up.
You put so much care, like you cared enough to go pick up a guitar.
Yes.
To help that
Thank
person.
You. I realize I can be a social worker through the guitar.
You can be. What are the gigs going on? Because
yeah.
all of a sudden you're out there
I've playing
with these
I've literally been on tour for 2 years.
Wow.
I'm so tired. And I have to say this because the internet still works. The way I got my first gig was I got a call from someone who saw a video I put on Instagram. It was a cover, it was 30 seconds.
Yeah.
You don't need a million view video to be discovered. All you need is the right person to see it. You know, I got the call, I was going to Chicago because I was so depressed, to be honest. I've been posting videos every day, no bites.
Yeah.
And I was just like, man, I'm gonna just take a break. I'm gonna go home with my grandma, gossip about the squirrels because they in the yard again. So I went there, and as soon as I got there, that's when I got the call. I went right back to Boston, and they said in 3 days, we're going on tour. That's when I got the call for the Fifth Harmony tour.
Fifth Harmony.
727 tour. That's when my friend Camila called me, and she said, we're gonna start touring. Do you wanna come? And I said, yeah.
So you're playing with her.
Yeah, so we did a couple Jingle Balls. We did some tours. To be honest, at this point, I can't really remember. It happened.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
much happened. Her mom called me. She was like, are you sitting down? I was like, what?
Okay.
What?
Yes.
She said, we're opening for Bruno Mars! Yeah. And I was playing like acoustic in these huge stadiums.
No pressure.
Oh, oh my goodness. It was crazy.
Wow.
So that brings me to this guitar.
Yeah, yeah.
And this guitar, this is a Tele. I usually play Strat, but for some reason, I felt like my career was elevating a little bit. I was like, let me go to this little Tele, see what's up.
All right.
So the thing I love about this guitar in particular, and the reason why I like this for the tour, is because it was so clean and crisp, and I felt like I was cutting through the mix
yeah,
more.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But in the context of a band, I personally felt like the Telecaster was a great option for me. And
yeah,
this one,
yeah.
particularly like the wood and everything, it just felt good and smooth.
It's a badass Telecaster, really.
It is.
I've noticed it's got the bigger knobs. Well, because it's also got the humbucker
yes.
pickups. So.
Yes. And I keep this little plastic on just to remind myself. You ain't made it. You ain't made it. You got to keep the little plastic on to remind yourself.
All right. Juno.
Yo.
The guitar is sick.
I love it.
And I actually do love Teles with humbuckers in them.
Yeah, they're cool.
It's a good combination. Can you just play a little
Sure.
song for us?
Let's see. You know what I want to play? I want to play the first song I learned from the 15-year-old heroin addict.
Let's do it. you've got another awesome guitar. Yes. This one looks a little more played in.
Yes, this is worn in. I got to thank my buddy Jordan for this, my guitar tech.
Do you know how old this guitar is?
I don't know.
Because it's like super...
Jordan, do you...
It was 1984. Ooh.
Nice.
19. It looks like Les Paul. This is the first Les Paul that Les Paul made. But yeah, it's just really smooth.
Yeah, they're clapping.
Okay, cool.
It's virtual clapping.
When I came to Nashville for the first time, since I've been playing music and stuff, not playing a show, but just to visit and do some sessions, I met this group of people who really believed in me and they wanted to manage me at the time. I came here to do a session, and the reason why this guitar is so special to me is because this is the guitar I used for the session. I actually said no. I was like, no, I don't wanna live in Nashville. So I left, toured, did all stuff.
Yep.
And now here I am back, and somehow I got this guitar. So I guess I'll play it.
In the gigs that you've done, like, what's the raunchiest you ever get with your tone? Do you ever go full out rock?
Insane.
Yeah.
When I did the Fifth Harmony tour, I was full out rock. And I think because I started like that, I think that's why now I'm exploring the more soft.
Yeah.
Because I really appreciate dynamic.
How many guitar players were in the Fifth Harmony tour? Like multiple?
Just me.
Just you.
Mm-hmm. Just me. And I was so proud because those guitar parts were really difficult.
Yeah.
Like you think it's just
How'd you learn them?
By ear. And yeah. I didn't tell them, I wasn't going to tell them I couldn't read or nothing like that.
Yeah.
I was just like, they were like, I was at my phone in the back learning the songs by ear because I didn't know that.
No, always say yes.
Yes, every guitar in a weird way, you kind of have to adjust to every guitar. Every guitar is unique. The neck is unique. The wood is unique. And while I don't know the specifics of all the terminology, I do know what feels good.
It's a
and
different
I do
child
know what doesn't. Yes.
Of yours.
It's a different child, and you have to understand how to maneuver it. And like for example, just now when I was playing. To be honest, when I started, I was like, I think I'm playing it too hard.
So that's
why I kept going, because I was like, I was trying to make it feel good for me.
Yeah.
So that's why all these guitars are awesome, but you know, it's been amazing to explore different ones and find the ones that feel good for me.
So the Tellies,
The Tellies
is number one.
Let me just say this, anything Taylor, because I have tried every company and I've been offered a lot of popsicles to change. I will not change. I love Taylor, like the smoothness and it just plays itself. Yeah. It's like butter.
And they're awesome for plugging in.
Yes, that's the thing. For tours and for stadiums,
I don't think there's a better stage acoustic.
Yeah, I would agree with that.
We were talking about Taylor guitars. I've got one here that's quite nice, and this is actually your guitar here.
This is
one's
my
not
guitar.
Mine, but this one's
this
yours.
This is my newest guitar. I don't know what it is about the tone of this guitar. It's just cool and it's just bouncy. Because I sit by myself and I do these little bouncy things because I'm just...
I can't see you doing that.
I know. I'm usually pretty calm, but sometimes, you know.
Yeah, I know. I really wish, you know, the one thing I wish from this episode is you just kind of like came out of your shell a little bit.
Yeah, well, we got to do a few more.
We'll do another one.
We'll redo it.
This is brand new.
Yes, this is brand new, and Tim Godwin sent this to me because he is the best person in the world.
He is really.
But also because he knows that I'm gonna play these things, man. And this guitar for me, this is the first guitar for me that I felt like was for me, for my needs, not for a tour, not for a session. It was more like, this guitar, for some reason, when I hold it, it's the best way that I express myself.
I like the types of headstocks, you know, where the strings go in like that. I just think they look cool.
They do, but they remind me of like Spanish guitars.
Yeah.
And I used to think if this was on there, that it had to be a Spanish guitar, but it's not true.
But I just think it looks cool.
Yeah, it looks cool, and this is a 322. Again, like, I think some people get caught up on like number, the higher the number, the better. Not necessarily.
No.
This guitar is the bomb, and I'm about to show.
Oh, absolutely. what's the goal that you haven't? Since you seem to be very good at reaching
out. I know. You know, to be honest with you, and that brings me to why I came to Nashville. Everything that's happened in the past year, I was just like, man, what other dream did I let go that I didn't think could happen? And to be honest, I want to be an artist. I want to be a person who writes songs, writes what I'm feeling and experiencing, and shares them with the world. Yeah. And I want to play shows and travel. I'm not one of those people that's afraid to admit. I want to do it at the highest level.
Yeah.
Because that's the dream.
Yeah, yeah.
And I think it's possible. I think it's gonna take a lot of hard work.
Yeah.
And I came to Nashville because the energy here is just where I am.
Yeah.
It's where my heart is, of just wanting to be connected with genuine people who wanna write amazing songs.
Yeah, you're in the right place.
Yeah,
for sure.
So that's why I'm here. What's next for me? To be honest, I'm here working on my album. I already wrote the whole album.
Okay.
So I'm more so here to record it. And then also I'm doing sessions. I mean, I'm now being introduced to the country world.
Yes.
So all of these, you know, Carrie Underwood and Keith Urban, all my heroes on the countryside, now I have an opportunity, hopefully, to work and meet with some of them
and do some stuff.
I hope so, you know. So I'm here to become an artist, but I'm not gonna stop playing and recording and stuff because I wanna contribute to music. Everything's not about money, opportunity, gigs. Sometimes you're just contributing to something that's bigger than you.
Yeah, yeah.
And to me, that's what we're doing.
So as we were talking earlier, it occurred to me that I recognized you from the show Empire.
Yes.
Because I watched that show.
Yes, it's me, Lonnie.
that's your character's name?
Yes, Lonnie. I don't know that they said it on the show yet,
but in the script it says it.
I am Lonnie, yes.
So tell me about that real quick, because that's just exciting.
I got to tell
you
this.
That's a really cool thing.
Man, you ain't going to believe this. This was the first time that I was like, you know what? I'm going to kind of be on my own and see how that feels. I went to the Grammys by myself, not playing for nobody else, not nothing. I just went, and I just sat as an audience member because I wanted to go to the Grammys, and I wasn't going to wait to be invited.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So I went. As I was there, I'm posting, obviously, my experience.
Yeah.
Now, the reason I'm saying this is because, again, no one knows what I'm doing there. I know that I wasn't there to work, but still. And on the outside, people were like, oh, wow, you know, whatever. So because of that, I don't know how, someone must have saw that from Empire, and they called me and said, we see that you're at the Grammys, can you come to Chicago?
Wow.
And I was just like, you see that I'm at the Grammys? Like, what is this? Like, social media is crazy. It's changed my life multiple times.
How long do you have to work for to do it?
Oh, it was like 2 months, I think, and it was long days, man. I thought the music world was tough. Those actors.
It's a lot of waiting around, right?
It's a lot of waiting around, but it's just like long days.
Yeah,
like long days, you know, so.
Juno, it's just been, I gotta come over.
Thank you. Oh, sorry.
Oh, that's okay.
Thank you so much for everything.
Thank you.
For all the stuff you don't even know you gave to me, man. I appreciate it.
Yeah.
And I'm out here. I'm trying.
I've been, you know, really moved hanging out with you today, so.
Thank you.
That's all I can say, do you have something that you'd like the people, like a link that people can go to?
Follow me on Instagram because right now that's gonna be my main place that I'm gonna be releasing all my stuff. And I'm just kind of treating Instagram right now like kind of like my diary blog.
Yes.
I'm not trying to be like getting good angles. I'm just letting y'all see what it is.
Yeah. So we'll make sure people can go to that and check it out. We were talking about this weird coincidence, the India RE song.
Yes, I'm a huge India RE fan.
So we filmed an episode of this Guitar Tours with Drew Ramsey, who co-wrote that whole album with her. So we want to give a shout out to Drew.
Shout out,
Ramsey.
Shout out, man.
Such a talented guy.
One of my favorite albums.
And we'll play one of the songs he did.